Hello students, myself Siddheshwar B. Tuljapure, Associate Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in this session, we are going to see the minor losses in the pipes. The learning outcome. So at the end of this session, students will be able to identify and calculate different types of minor losses in a piping system. The contents, the definition of the minor loss, then it is different types of minor losses, and calculation of minor losses, and then lastly, the references. Definition of minor loss. So minor losses are the losses which are occurring due to the change in the velocity. Now, as we are knowing, the velocity, it can be changed in the form of the magnitude or also in the direction. So as it is a vector quantity, we can have only change in direction also, and in some cases we might have the change in the magnitude also. So if the velocity is changing, in case of that one, the minor loss, it is going to occur. There are different reasons why the minor losses, these are occurring. So in this case, the first one, it is at the entrance of a pipe. This is the first. The second one, so it is due to sudden enlargement of pipe. Third one, due to sudden contraction of pipe. The fourth one, due to bend in a pipe. The fifth one, due to obstruction in the pipe. Sixth one, in various pipe fittings. And the last one, it is at the exit or outlet of the pipe. Now let us see one by one the different types of the losses. The first one, it is the minor losses at the entrance of a pipe. Now we can see that here we are having this one as a tank, and the pipe, it is connected to this one. So this section is the section where the pipe is connected to the tank. So this is called as entrance of the pipe, or it is the inlet of a pipe. So in case of the entrance or inlet of the pipe, the loss is occurring, and that loss is given by the formula. The head loss at the inlet is equal to, it is 0.5 into V square by 2G. So now in this case, the velocity V, it is the velocity of the liquid in the pipe. The velocity of the liquid in the tank, it is going to be zero. So when it enters into the pipe, the fluid particles, they are gaining the velocity, and the velocity in the pipe, it is required for the calculation purpose. Next to that one, the second one, it is the minor losses due to sudden enlargement of pipe. So in case of the diagram, you can observe that we are having initially the diameter of the pipe as lesser. Then suddenly the diameter of the pipe, it has increased at this section, and the enlarged section, it is lying towards the right hand side. So now we can consider the two different sections, section 1-1 and section 2-2. At the section 1, we are having the cross section area different and lesser than that of the cross section area at the section number 2 it is. So in case of this, we are going to have the suppose velocity at the section 1, it is V1, and the velocity at the section 2, it is V2. The head loss here, it is dependent upon both the velocities. Now here you can observe that, say we are going to have the formation of the eddies here. So the eddies, these are formed due to the, say, increase in the cross section area. So according to the continuity equation, when we are going to have the discharge as constant, if the cross section area increases, we are going to have the decrease in the velocity. So decrease in the velocity will lead to increase in the pressure, and due to the increase in the pressure, so the reverse flow, it is going to start, and the formation of the eddies will be there here, and say due to that one, to some extent the losses will be there. So we are going to have also, so the loss at, due to the sharp edge, etc., to some extent we might have. Then the head loss due to the sudden enlargement, it is given by the formula V1 minus V2. This is in the bracket, and that bracket square divided by it is 2G. Third one, it is the minor loss due to sudden contraction of pipe. So exactly opposite to the earlier one we are having here. The cross section area, it has suddenly decreased at this particular section. So here, due to the sharp edge, again we are going to have the losses, And here again at the section CC, we can observe that here the vena contracta, it has been formed. That is, the cross section area of that particular flow or jet, it is going to be smallest, and then again it acquires the entire cross section area of the pipe, and then at section 22 again the full flow is there. So here the head loss due to the sudden contraction, it is equal to, it is given by the formula, it is 0.5 into it is V square by V2 square by it is 2G. That is, the loss is dependent upon the velocity at the section 2 only. So minor losses due to the bend in a pipe. So in case of the bend, we can observe that here we are going to have the direction vertically upwards initially, and then we are going to have the direction of the fluid towards the right hand side. So when we are going to have the liquid changing the direction, we are going to have the head loss. So it is purely due to the direction change it is, and here we are not going to have any cross section area changing. And the minor loss due to the bend in a pipe, it can be given by the formula. Here it is HB is equal to, it is KB into it is V square by 2G, where KB corresponds to the coefficient of the bend. Now think about the losses in the two parts which we are calling it as, one it is bend, the second one it is the elbow. Both are capable of changing the direction through the right angle, and then we are going to have the losses here also and here also. So what do you think, where the losses will be more, whether it is in bend or whether it is in elbow? See, the answer is elbow, because in case of the elbow, you can observe that the sudden change in the direction it is occurring. So from here to here, the sharp change is there, whereas in case of the bend, the curvature it is larger radius, and we are going to have the smooth change in the direction in case of the bend, whereas in case of the elbow, so less radius of curvature is there and sudden change in the direction is occurring. Hence, the losses in the elbow, these will be more it is. So, but the space required by the elbow, these will be lesser. Accordingly, we should be able to select it is. The minor loss due to an obstruction in the pipe. Say sometimes an obstruction might come in the SI pipes, and say it will be to the flow. And then in case of this, we are going to have the obstruction here, which is shown hatched. And then section 1-1 we have taken here, where it is going to be largest in the cross section area, and then section 2-2 it is the normal cross section area of the pipe it is. So head loss due to the obstruction, it is given by V square by 2G into bracket, it is A, capital A refers to the cross section area of the pipe, CC refers to again coefficient of contraction. Here again the vena contracta it is going to form, and then we are going to have the, again the enlargement in the cross section area of the flow. So coefficient of contraction it is coming here also. And small a refers to the maximum area of obstruction, and say it is minus, it is 1 is there. So with the help of this formula, we can determine the head loss due to the obstruction. Minor loss in various pipe fittings. So different types of the pipe fittings we are generally using, like say different types of the valves are there. So flow control valves are there, or shut-off valves are there, or say we can also go for the different types of the couplings to join the two pipes, etc. So in case of those, head loss in the pipe fittings, that is HFI, it can be calculated, or it can be given by the formula KFI, referring to the coefficient of fittings, and then the formula is KFI into it is V square by it is 2G is there. So the last one, so in case of the last one, we are having the minor loss at the exit or outlet of the pipe. So now here we can observe that we are having one pipe which is connected to this tank, tank number suppose 1, and the pipe is connected again to the tank number 2. So here also the connection is there, here also connection is there. Now from left to right, when the flow is occurring, at that time, this is going to become inlet and this is going to become the exit or outlet of the pipe. So in case of the exit or outlet of the pipe, we are going to have the losses as given by the formula. It is V square by 2G. So H at outlet is given by the formula. It is V square by 2G. Now in all, we have observed that the bend or the elbow, these are the say only parts which are changing, say the direction of the fluid, and they are not changing the velocities. So similar to this one, we can have the other fittings also. So like say the 45 degree elbow you can have instead of the say 90 degree or 60 degree, etc. we can have. So minor losses, these are corresponding to both, that is the change in the direction and also the change in the magnitude of the velocity. If it is occurring, then also the minor losses, these are going to occur. These are the references. Thank you.